Yo, CPA Strength here, back again with another video. My best accounting for beginners video ever, and that's saying something because this is accounting for beginners number 95. This is my 95th one, so we try to get a little bit better every time. I have a whole complete playlist. Please click this card. You go to the playlist, all the accounting videos I have, you can look at them at your leisure. I'm telling you, it will help you. I appreciate all the comments, all the likes, all the everything. I've been grinding on this hard for like 3 years. Had to take off some months, but we are back now. And I love doing these videos. I love helping people. And we're gonna try to make new improvements to our new studio and the YouTube quality as we go. I just wanna give some information in this one. Don't really have a name so much for this video, except it's 95. I got a comment. Thank you for leaving the comment. Comments or questions get read all the time. Quite frankly, if you leave a question, I could possibly make a video out of it. At least I know it'll help one person, and if one person has a question about it, then I'm sure a whole bunch of other people have questions about it. But anyways, thank you for watching. Let's just get into this. Question, very good question. It said, I like to see if I actually understood everything this mnemonic tells us. Okay. And this person has six different things, and I have two more to add. So I have eight things that the eight letters DC Adler will tell you. If you don't know about DC Adler, please click the link to the playlist or go to my channel and watch some of my other videos or type in DC Adler. In the YouTube search bar, you find a bunch of my videos. DC Adler is, and that's the mnemonic he's talking about. DC Adler is debit, credit, DC, debit, credit, aid, asset, draw, expense, LER, liability, equity, revenue. And just as I've been doing this and teaching this system for the past 3 years, I wish I would have started with this withdraw. I wish I would have started teaching with withdraw, because draw, I think of like drawing something, and it doesn't really make sense to me. It's more of a personal withdraw from a business account is this. So what are the six things that this commenter, thank you very much for leaving the comment, thought, hey, what's, you know, I'd like to see if I actually understood everything this mnemonic tells us. Number one, it tells us that debits and credits aren't positive or negative by themselves. Simply, that debits go on the left, credits go on the right. Absolutely correct. Absolutely correct. All debit is left. Well, there's more, but I mean, that's what it means. I think it's the Latin root word. And credit is right. So you will learn that going through the whole process. So this person is absolutely correct on that. What else does this tell you? Number two, he wants to know, it tells us the big six types of accounts. Draws, withdrawals, expenses, assets, liabilities, equity, in quotes, owner stock, and revenue. So yeah, it tells you the big six types of accounts. He has draws, withdraw. Yep. There's one. Second one, expenses, yes. Third one he has, asset, yes. We have liabilities, yes, there's our fourth one. Then we have equity, owner's equity, or stock
in the company.
Yes, that's the fifth one. Sixth one, revenue. So yeah, absolutely, number two, it tells you the six big types of accounts. Yes, it does. Number three, It tells us the accounting equation whereby assets and liability over equity. I'm not sure where he was going with his accounting equation, but it does tell you the accounting equation. The accounting equation is assets equal liabilities plus equity. Now let me just tell you that the seventh, one of my own things that this person does not have is that debits equal credits. Always, always, always equal credits. Debits equal credits. Debits equal credits. Okay? Debit in your journal entries, debits always equal credits. So, he wants to know, it shows you the ass, if you know, debits always equal credits, debits on the left, credits on the right. What's the accounting equation? Assets, hold on here, let me use a different marker. He's saying that the assets equal liabilities plus equity, which it definitely, definitely does. Sorry about the lighting, everybody. I don't know where my other light is right now. So I only have one, and I know this is kind of weird, but I'm sorry, I just want to get some content out, get back in the groove, and, you know, Rome wasn't built in a day. If I just waited till everything was perfect, I'd have no videos on my channel instead of 310 videos, so. Absolutely, it shows you the accounting equation. Assets equal liabilities plus equity. What's the next one he says? It tells us that each of the accounts is placed on the side where they are increased. DE and A are increased by debits, while LE and R are increased by credits. Yes, it shows you the, it starts off with the side that it increases. So, if an asset, if a withdrawal or an expense is increasing in value, it would be a debit. If a liability, equity, or revenue is increasing in value, it would be a credit. Number five, it tells us the opposite of the above. DEA are decreased by credits. Right, if asset, withdrawal, or expense are decreasing, you credit it. If liability, equity, and revenue are debits, they're going down. Number six, it tells us the normal balance for each of the big six accounts. Normal balance, if it's a positive balance. So the seventh one I said, it shows that they equal each other, DC Adler. And the eighth, it also has the income statement on here, which is revenue minus expenses. Anyways, thank you for watching. I have a lot to get back to get back in my groove. I hope this helped people. We are in the new semester for school, so I'm trying to go back, and I'm trying to put out a lot of content, and I'm really gonna make a go of this YouTube thing this time. I've been going hard for a while. But anyways, until next video, I really appreciate you watching, and deuces.